Hi, my name is Bill McNeely, and I want to welcome you to my brand new YouTube channel. Just because you're 60, and you might even be considered a senior citizen, that don't mean you're washed up or you have to be technically challenged. My name is Bill McNeely, and I want to welcome you to my brand new YouTube channel. Just turned 60 years old today, and I was talking to my goddaughter, and she was encouraging me. I'm a media guy. I do photography and videography. I've done it for a number of years, and I have been procrastinating about doing product reviews. So guess what? On my 60th birthday, I'm going to do a product review. Just because you're 60 and you might even be considered a senior citizen, that don't mean you're washed up or you have to be technically challenged. If you're like me and you know you got a whole lot of life in you and left to live, I'm committed to not being a victim of the digital divide. I don't need my grandkids to teach me about tech. So weekly, I want to just give you tech straight with no chaser, keep it simple, and show you that anybody at any age can do media and be effective and reach people and promote their cause, what they're doing, and help people and do tutorials or whatever it is. So today, I like to keep it simple and easy. I don't like carrying a lot of crap around, but I need something that's effective and efficient to get the job done. And so I'm reviewing the Canon M50, my favorite runaround camera. I do a lot of shoots with it to accomplish, it accompanies some of my other DSLRs, and this thing is off the chain. You know, some of the specs on it, it's a 24 megapixel camera. It has a Digic 8 processor. It shoots crappy 4K, but most people, their platforms don't support 4K anyway, so it's just overkill for the most part. 1080 is just crystal clear and it's sharp. You can use 4K. The crop is quite a bit on it. You need a wide angle lens and you need to put it in manual focus so it don't hunt on you, but don't even worry about that because most people are consuming video content on their iPhones or their iPads or their tablets anyway. And so, I do video commercials for clients. I do photography, and I take this as a spare camera with me a lot, as a backup camera, just in case something happened. I believe if I'm on a photo shoot, you better have a spare. You never know what's gonna happen. You can have a card fail or anything, but you know what? The truth of the matter is, this thing with this 22 millimeter prime lens is what I keep on here 90% of the time. On a crop sensor body, it's like a 38 millimeter equivalent that kind of give you a true to life picture form. It gets the job done. I've been shooting with this thing for about 9 months and I absolutely love it. Some of the benefits when I'm shooting, nobody looks at the old guy with the big camera. I think you're a professional. It's small, so they don't think you're getting good video. People don't freeze up. They don't even take you serious. So I get away with murder with this thing, and I don't mean that literally, but I do. It takes great shots. You put it, the kit lens that come with it, I had a 15 to 45, and it works okay outside, but you know, it's a slow lens. It's a f3.5 to 5.6. Indoors, if the lighting is crappy, if you don't have a light, it'll struggle, but you can make it work. I mean, start where you're at. This thing, I think I got the creator's kit with this thing for about $750. Best Buy price matched off of Amazon. It came with a card. It came with a road video mic, a smaller one that you don't have to switch on, that was really good. I traded that out with my godson for some more equipment because I already have some Rode mics that are good. But this thing has been phenomenal. I am a professional in the sense that I charge people to make videos and do portrait photography for them, or every now and then I do weddings. I think my niche is doing portrait photography because I take your picture and I'm pretty good in Lightroom and I make it look fantastic. I'll take 30 years off of you. So this thing has been getting the job done, okay? It really does. Sometimes, you know, I'll set up two or three cameras and do the multi-cam thing. That's for another video. But if you're just getting started, this is user-friendly and you can get started with no hassle. I've had absolutely no trouble. It don't have a headphone jack in it, but it works just fine. If you're lazy like me, you don't want to set up all of that stuff. With this 22 millimeter f2 prime lens on there, it's pretty doggone good in low light. Now, you might be wondering, well, what is he shooting on now? Well, I believe in keeping it simple, keep it safe, keep it inexpensive, and keep it practical. Because so my first YouTube video, I'm doing it on my iPhone. And so I talk to a lot of people, especially some guys my age, and they make things just way too complicated. I've learned that you can learn anything and you can shoot with the best of them. I've taken this camera along with some of my older cameras and gone in churches because I specialize in doing promotions for churches and videos and stuff like that. And I've had pastors say, oh, you got your little Canons. And they got these great big cameras up on tripods, four or five of them. They don't know how to use them, but you're paying me to come in to do your promotions. And I take this little camera along with my other favorite camera, my 80D, most of the time, and I get anything done I need to do, and it's great. The footage, if you using an equivalent lens on my 80D, I use like a 24 millimeter lens. It's a 2.8. That's a little slower than this one. I love this one. This is f2. This is great, and most of the time, on my other camera, I throw that nifty 50, that 1.8, f1.8 Canon lens on at a prime, and I put it on there, and the footage looks awesome, I'm telling you. So you don't need a big budget. I've talked to a lot of leaders and pastors and churches, and guess what? They have seen the results that I'm getting. I'm gonna do a cutaway of some footage I just did. I do video business cards, promotions for nonprofits. I'm gonna cut away. You'll see it, it'll be on the screen, of some of the footage I've shot with this camera, man. And it's the bomb. So I am committing to do a weekly vlog once a week about tech. I'll review tech, cell phones. I'll review other camera stuff. I'm pissed off with the Poulsen company. I was shooting a wedding and I bought this wireless audio system and the antenna fell off this thing the first day. So this will be my first rant next week. I'll be talking about this. They don't make any parts for it, so I'm just stuck. Okay, I got family not understanding my new YouTube experience. But that's okay. So I'm gonna tell you what's good and what's crappy out there, what works. I'm gonna show you shortcuts. Oftentimes, if I'm shooting some, I don't set up big lights. So you'll just know this is a light that gets really bright off of Amazon. Look at that. Look at all that golden love right here. Come on now. I can light up New York with this thing, and I think I paid about $18 for it. So you don't need all of that crap. to get the job done. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna give you practical advice. I'm not gonna shove it down your throat. If you wanna take it, you take it. If you don't, you don't. But I'm gonna show you how to get the job done easy. Oftentimes it depends on the client's budget. But if you don't can't afford to pay me for all of my extra work, sometimes I'll come in with this thing and shoot you an automatic. You know, I don't worry about all of that because it adjusts to light in well. The auto white balance in the thing is real good. I take it and throw it in the final cut, do some tweaks on the color and coloring and fix it up, and it looks just wonderful and it looks perfect. So this is Bill McNeely, and I'm here to give you practical insight on technology. Just because you are an older person, you don't have to be a victim to technology, but you can utilize it like crazy. So I'm gonna show you what works for me and what will make you a little chump change on the side. So I look forward to seeing you next week. Bill McNeely, you don't have to be a victim to technology and fall into a technical rut. And I look forward to sharing with you. If you like this video, as they always want to say it, smash that button. Come on now, help an old guy out, glory to God, and it's gonna be good. If you have any questions or comments on this video, I'm not a pro, this is my first time. Please excuse my YouTube, I taught myself how to do it with just a little coaching, and it's gonna be good, and I will be back soon. Talk to you later, bye-bye.